And we're back with another thrilling episode of Let's Play Pillars of Eternity Blind. I'm about to head down these stairs. This was all water here, but we messed with this thing. I think there's a chain that we pulled. I wonder if we could see. No. And it lowered the water level, so down we go.
Got it.
We're already sneaking. Lesser black ooze, huh? I'm wondering if it even can come up on the steps at all. Interesting. Glad to be fighting something other than, shadows? Yeah, check out the bestiary and talk about the ooze and the, what's the other thing we saw? The other spirit type thing. Oh, phantom.
Eh?
Ooh, they throw ooze at us. That's nasty. Interrupted? Oh, we can interrupt them. So I guess they've missed us so far. Two more lesser black oozes. Let them come to us, I say. Okay. Finish this one off. You know what? Have her, have Theodos use this. Is it my? Is that gonna even work? And these things don't have mines. How about amplified thrust? I use that on him, or whoever. There we go.
Yes.
Oh wow. Make a complete runaround. Now if we could knock them down, they'd be knocked down. How are we doing? We're okay. Is it still alive? Yeah. Okay. This one's pretty damaged. It's gonna hit her. Right? Yeah, everyone else just wail on it. All right. Down to just one. I say we just melee it down. Don't seem to have that many hit points. There you go. Not bad at all. Ooh, they dropped Jasperus. Look at that. Both, of course. Ooze plasma. A congealed mass of thick and opaque jelly. Alright, that's all of that.
My eyes are peeled.
That might hurt. Alright, let's check. Bestiary. Lesser black ooze. Look at that thing. An ooze is a mobile carnivorous mold that develops in dark, dank places that experience little to no regular traffic. Oozes feed off of ambient bacteria, fungi, and small insects as they grow. They begin to seek larger prey, including humans, once they reach the size of a dog. Oh, are we talking Bichon, or are we talking Greyhound? Like all living creatures, they have a measure of soul essence, but their lack of intelligence and a true nervous system makes them mindlessly aggressive and difficult to deter. Their viscosity and mobility enable them to perform surprisingly nimble attacks, and they are capable of splitting corrosive enzymes to break down flesh and armor. Some of the more dangerous variants of the species are disease vectors, making any confrontation with them especially perilous. How about these phantoms? Did we see this? Phantom? Do we read about phantoms? Let me read about it. I'm gonna read about it. Yeah, I don't think I've read this one. I think I got it confused with Shadow. Phantoms are souls that did not properly separate from the body after death. This usually happens as a result of severe... I'm looking at the damage reduction for burn and freeze. This usually happens as a result of severe trauma, particularly in the case of a violent death. Unlike lost souls, which are incapable of interacting with or being detected by normal mortals, phantoms like Shadows and Sinwila maintain a connection to the physical world. They will attack other life forms without discrimination. Phantoms can also manifest from Kith who lived particularly chaotic lives, including violent criminals and the insane. Anyone can become a phantom under the right circumstances. But the fear of phantoms and their association with the mentally ill can result in vulnerable populations being shunned across many communities. And they're level 3. We defeated 2 of them. Oh, okay. I thought they were easier to destroy than the shadows. Maybe I just had some weak ones?
No problem.
Ooh, we've got some kind of cloak or something down there. Maybe it's a key for that door in there? Because we can't open it. Mechanics 5 we need. Gleaming silver key. This large silver key catches the light strangely, seeming to glow. Alright. I would say that's it.
Nice and quiet.
Back up here. Well, that was a surprise. I figured there would be an enormous labyrinth of rooms down there as well. So what could be in here that's gotten in without the use of the key? Unless whatever it is, whoever owned that cloak locked them in here and then got killed by the oozes. Well, that's another shadow. Out of how many? Hopefully it's the only one.
Yeah.
Hello. You give us boo-boos. Where's Eothas? Is it him? That's Firebrand. You know, I should have had him move back. These things always like to hit him.
What is it?
It's this thing. Destroy it. He's got four of these still? Now if she can aim, she can do a mind wave if she aims like this way. Even then she won't hit her. I don't know, is this target friendlies or not? Oh, do we kill it? Wait, is it? Oh, it moved. Hate when it does that. Move over there. I'm surprised that wasn't an attack of opportunity or whatever.
Nice and quiet.
Oh, everyone. Would you be leading the team, Eothas?
Yes, I shall.
No, you shan't. Well, make me lay the smackdown on you. Oh, we're going down to the third level? Is that our puzzle? Our puzzle for the second level was harder. Oh, maybe not. This is just a small staircase. Saving. Another ooze. That might be one too.
Yeah.
We got a shadow. Who's this? Theodas? Why are you in back?
Yes.
Oh, crap. I mean, these aren't so bad, but... I don't think she can knock down things, these things. They can't be knocked prone. Okay, so amplified thrust on Firebrand. Arcane assault on this thing.
And
Did we get rid of the... No. Oh, it's not barely damaged. Oh boy. Firebrand. She is hitting this thing, right? Soul Shock. Off of fire. Oh, it can hit all these things. Great. Attack. Yeah, everyone just attack this thing. Yeah, she's down. If we could just kill the Phantom. Which we've done so, yay. Now who's really damaged? Two of them. Where's he? He's back here. Just let him move over there. She'll hit this thing. Because I want to see how badly flames damage them. Awesome. Oh, good. Done. Oh boy. I'm gonna save right here, because I'm hoping I've completely cleared out this room and we can camp here. Some more ooze plasma.
I shall.
Eh?
Unless we're gonna find some more.
My eyes are peeled.
Camping supplies. We're gonna have to head back to get more. The still dark waters are reflective as black glass. This some kind of lever or something. Oh, and stairs up. Interesting. We're not going to camp in there. Let's go by the door. Yeah, we need it for her, right? Actually, her health isn't that bad. What do you think? Should we continue? Can we continue on? I figured she was really messed up. Still got 152 health.
Yeah. No problem.
Yeah, let's go on actually. On second thought.
Quickly and quietly.
I'm gonna go check out this lever, and I know there's stairs up there. What's that sound? Oh, is that? Ah. Is that a monster? There's a screech of metal and a snapping noise as you pull the lever. Oh. What's that? Oh my. It's pretty much just exactly what I would say. We can talk to it? Lost spirit. The light rises from the bones as you approach. You have a moment to register the faintest image of a standing figure. Features a blur of mist and smoke. Or smoke before the world tilts. It is as if you have stepped sideways and into a new life. You are racing down a flight of stairs, following a weaving circle of torchlight. Your own panting breaths are loud in your ears. Panic and your robes alike foul your steps, and you nearly stumble before a hand reaches out to grip your arm and steady you. A fellow acolyte who smiles encouragement as you reach the bottom. You run around and past a shallow reflection pool that marks the lowest point of the temple, following the dark shapes of the older priests as they lead the way towards the narrow hall that leads to the vault. You pass one of the torchbearers as you go. The harsh illumination of the flames reveals a familiar face. For a moment, your awareness spans time and identity, and you think Wurtan has joined you. Here, at the bottom of the temple, in the memory, he glances at you for a moment, and then looks past at someone else. Is Wurtan the one upstairs who sent us on this journey? Wurtan. Let me check my log after this. I'll come back once they're gone, he's saying. You're being pressed along by the crowd, and his words are growing faint. Just keep quiet. We can't take any chances. Inside the vault, golden relics gleam like welcoming stars. It looks like there's a lot of treasure around here. The memory twists, jarring you loose from one moment and plunging you into another like a flung doll. There is only darkness around you now. You think yourself blinded until the knowledge settles onto you like a cloak. The candles have all burnt away. You know now, too, with a sick certainty, that nobody is coming. There's a crackling noise somewhere to your left. A wet, slurping gurgle, and a ragged sob. You cannot see, and so you cannot know which brother or sister has fallen, and which digs after what water a body may provide. You hear, in the faint murmuring to your right, the familiar cadence of prayer, but you no longer recognize the words. You are too tired to do harm. The thirst is like fire within you. Your tongue is thick in your throat, and every breath is a struggle that leeches strength from you. There is a light, they said, at the end of every bout of darkness, but this one does not end. The lost spirit releases you, and you come back to yourself, in pieces. Your vision clears, and the vault around you is revealed once more, cast in muted hues by the sickly illumination of the soul still drifting like fading fog. Fear wafts off the spirit in waves, fraying at your own emotions. Who's to be afraid of you, right, Dad? I'm sorry. I hope you find some peace in the next life. The spirit seems to withdraw into itself. You sense loss of its fear and confusion as it recedes, but the soul lingers still. Leave the remains for now. Because now it's gone. There are faint scratches upon the brickwork by the door hinges. This rock stands unsteadily on its base. It seems that the mechanism is broken. We were locked in here and then died. How awful. Some of the gold leaf on these relics has chipped away to reveal the wood beneath. There are tooth marks upon one of the bowls. Damn. Skeletons cover the floor, frozen in their final moments of agony. You feel a presence in the air, like a physical weight. If we take the stuff, they're gonna attack. Guaranteed. Here's, 9 copper skeets. Let's go into sneak
mode.
Time
to see and not be seen.
See if any of this stuff is trapped. Can't get very close to it, can I?
I'll see what I can do.
Well, we did it. Gorn's share. A one-handed flail. A lesser-known aspect of the god Eothas, Gorn represents the cyclic nature of life and the seasons, and is often portrayed as a farmer wielding a scythe. He enjoys popularity among more rural followers of Eothas, who are drawn to his varying identities as provider, shepherd of the dead, and defender against injustice. Gorn's share is said to have been crafted by a distraught deerwooden smith after the destruction of his home by a Glamfellen raiding party. Upon arriving at a neighboring settlement, the smith immediately set about his work, intending to craft a weapon suited to righting the wrongs done to his village. Toiling over several weeks, he was able to fashion a heavy flail covered in small, sickle-shaped blades, with which he was determined to send any returning invaders into the afterlife. I want to compare with her. Did we take it? Did we even take it? Hold on. No, we didn't even take it. Speed average. Speed fast. Damage 10 to 5. Now, what I found out about the, what do you call it? I was gonna say psionic. The cipher. Is that the faster the weapon the cipher deals, the better, because the more hits you get in, the more your will, not your will, sorry, I'm still trying to get familiar with all the terminology here, the more your focus increases. So I think we're going to have her use this Gorn's share. It does look like a pretty awesome weapon. And we've got a pry bar. Another pry bar. Put it in there because we've got a pry bar already. Alright. We actually bought one. Oh well. So we'll sell one. Okay. So she's got the flail now. Ooh, a moonstone. Moonstone derives its name from its moonlight-like luster and is sometimes collected by Andra's gift bearers, who associate the stone's presence in the world with the legends of Andra's love affair with the moon. Okay. Now's the part where I save the game because we're gonna get in some kind of fight. Yeah, whatever. I was gonna have her fighter go up, but she'll probably die quicker than Theodas would. Gather the remains. You spend a few moments gathering up what you can find of the bones of the priests. It provides a heavy and gruesome burden, but you manage to recover them all. Oh! We looked in there. Okay. So where are they? We stick them in our stash. Oh, we did! Dead priest's bones. This is a grisly assortment of weathered bones and skulls belonging to the Eothasian priests lost within the temple at Gilded Vale. Awesome! So we've completed our quest. We still have a little bit left to explore, or at least a little bit.
Keeping an eye out.
See, why is he in front again? What is it I'm not getting? I kind of want him in the back. It doesn't make sense the way this is laid out to me. It just doesn't make sense to me. Alright. Well, if this works, we'll make it work. Yeah, I guess. Alright. I guess it's in rows from here. I guess so. What's up here? Well, there's a Skuldr whelp. Here they come.
Yes.
Can I do Fan of Flames again? Hey, look at that. Try to get rid of that one first. Though the Fan of Flames might very well just kill it down the rest of the way. Kill it down the rest of the way, that's what I like. Mind Blades we cast on a foe. Now they have minds, such as they are. Watch this. Unfortunately, they moved. Her spell is still going. Hurt. Oh, that's a Skuldr King! Holy crap. Alright, Eloth. What else you want to cast? How about... How about we cast Necrotic Lance? First time casting it, believe it or not. And yeah, we're running quite late with the episode, unfortunately. She can't do mind wave, no. How about soul shock? If she survives that long. I think she's down. Cast it on him.
Lava will be on seek.
Hold on. I'm not sure what I was doing there. Wait. I'm targeting someone. Targeting our fallen fighter, I think. That didn't do much. Oh my god, he must have hit her really hard.
Yeah.
Hurry up. Again. Oh my god, he's really tough, isn't he? Do you have any? No. And we can't run. Oh, she fell. Yeah. Bye-bye. All right, guys. I'm gonna camp. Definitely gonna camp now and return to this, and we'll see what we can do. Thanks for watching. See you next time in a bang bang boogie, and don't stop the boogie.